I was thinking of Pilot Babaji Ashram. The story of my connection with the Pilot Babaji is by itself quite interesting for me, because I came to know about him in the end of 80s. And you know, at that time, end of 80s, the very, very beginning of 90s, I was so impressed by his personality that, you know, if you could ask me to which guru I want to go to India, at that time I could say like Pilot Babaji. But it so happened that I met him for the first time, you know, something like 2013 or 2014, so like actually many years later. And as you know, so my life happened in such a way that I met my guru Yogi Rama, then Satyasai Baba and some other masters. Whatever, but anyways, it's a long story of my connection with Pilot Baba. And since last, well, something like 4 years, 5 years, I'm like every year I'm visiting his ashram, and it's nice for me to stay there because I'm working on my new books like that, practicing meditations, sometimes receiving some good advices from Pilot Babaji. And of course now he is something like 8 years old. Yeah, he's quite strong for his age, and now he is in such you know, state of consciousness when he is he speaks much less than it was previously. He's just sitting peacefully in his armchair. Yeah, I mean, it's a wonderful experience for me because he's just in a really blissful state, and it's good to sit next to him and just practice japa or meditation. You know, my connection with him, if I may describe it, is just a visitor, okay? Just kind of friendship. I'm not his disciple, so I'm just sitting next to him and enjoying and you know, working on my new book. That's how I'm staying there. But I think for his disciples, it's not so easy right now to be in his ashram, because that's my feeling, because in 80s and 90s he was so active, so like dynamic, and he was conducting like huge number of workshops and retreats, and you know, he gave a lot of instructions on meditation and Kriya Yoga at that time, I mean 80s and 90s. But the last 10 years he's, you know, scarcely saying something, and not so many instructions like how to practice meditation, japa, etc. And I think that some of his disciples now, they feel like gap, and some really, really, they need more instructions about sadhana, about meditation. And that's how it's happened right now. And I mean, those who already practice meditation and mantra, know how to practice, they just enjoy, because they just stay next to him and just enjoy. But those who need like more verbally, like instruction, okay, like how to do this, how to do that, for that kind of people, it's slightly problematic, so slightly difficult to stay there now. But anyway, like, yeah, and you know, July, it was first of all Guru Purnima, and normally he organizing this fire ceremony, fire worship for 3-5 days, this year I made something like 10 or 11 videos about that Homa, he's just how he's sitting with the people, and each of them like, you know, 12 to 15 minutes with my mantra, with my mantra music. And yeah, I think it's unique, like, to that I have chance to sit and meditate next to him and make that videos, because, you know, now he's more than 8 years old, and we hope that he will stay longer, but we don't know for how long. And unfortunately, not so many people really doing all that videos. That's also sad, actually. But I'm I'm trying to use my camera more actively, because it's a part of spiritual history right now. Well, his main guru was Hari Baba, which is the very interesting yogi from Nepal, and well, he that's the main guru of Pilot Babaji, but also some other yogis gave him some blessings and instructions, including, by the way, Devraha Baba also. Even Devraha Baba, he gave some blessings to him, and it's a mysterious question, you know, what kind of Mahatmas he met. There are quite a lot of speculation about this. Sometimes we think that he met Mahadhar Babaji and Goraknath, but sometimes Pilot Babaji himself, he actually, at least now, he denying that, actually. And difficult to say what is the meaning of that. Maybe he just doesn't want to speak about this. He doesn't want to create more fantasies about this, because you know, I was that moment next to him when somebody asked him about Mahavatar Babaji, are the immortals, and you know, his answer was like, you know, like, are you sure that all that immortals exist at all? Yeah, you know, just rumors, forget about them, just practice more meditation, do not indulge in all that crazy ideas. And you know, who knows, maybe he is right, because it's like what's happened right now, more and more yoga practitioners and meditation practitioners just creating a lot of crazy ideas about immortal masters. And you know, the point, if we practice meditation seriously, then it's nice to know about them. But what's happened, sometimes people forgetting to practice meditation and the mantra, but they keep on thinking and trying to meet even like all that immortal Mahatmas, forgetting to practice. And even like when we read autobiography of a yogi by Yogananda, you know, as I already mentioned, that yeah, many Westerners and modern Indians, they read this book, they like, wow, in a state of absolute like wonder and enthusiasm about this information about immortal Babaji. But then, you know, when they come really in touch with any Kriya Yoga tradition, then they come to know that, okay, Kriya Yoga is actually a set of exercises and meditation techniques, and that's, oh no, that's borrowed, that we don't want. We want to meet Mahavatar Babaji, but we don't want to practice meditation. So that's maybe the reason why Pilot Babaji, he just tell to the people, forget about it, you know, who knows, maybe that's just fantasy, who knows, like, just practice more meditation then.
yes, people likes to talk, just talk.
Yeah, but, and of course, that meditation techniques which he's like preaching to the people, yeah, in some sense, similarity is there with our tradition, but okay, like, you know, I just may repeat that in 80s and 90s, he himself, I mean, Pilot Babaji, was more like a person with a good structure and a very active guru, but now is not so good structure in his spiritual instructions, and actually people want to listen more about techniques, but just sometimes he's giving all that, sometimes his helpers leading seminars. But anyway, it's extremely powerful yogi, and a great experience for me, like especially last 4 years, really to spend time with him. He actually normally he gives like kind of four levels of initiation. And the first is the Guru Diksha, and just take person as a disciple and give some certain mantra. And the next level is samskara diksha. Samskara means, okay, purification of some, if we'll describe it in slightly in the modern way, it's like, okay, this garbage from our subconscious mind, we have to purify like that. This is the second level of initiation. You know, the Guru Diksha, as far as I know, he gives like, you know, a couple of hours in the morning, like that. And Samskara Diksha, it's happened like whole night. You know, people stay in Shavasana and some huge purification happened. And, you know, I went through the process of Samskara Diksha some, well, let me see, in the end of 90s in the ashram of Bhagavan Kalkin. And at that time, that was huge program, like, you know, one time it was some 25 days, you know, not one night, but 25 days. I was staying in Shavasana and doing all that subconscious mind purification. And the second time it was like something like 2 weeks, 14 days, like also. So more or less I may imagine what it is. Okay, third level of initiation in Pilot Babaji's tradition is actually Sankalpa Diksha, means again like the possibility, the power to create positive intention. And this kind of dikshas I received from Yogi Ramak, and some instructions from Ganapati Sachidananda Swami, because he is working with Sankalpa Yoga quite a lot. And the fourth and the last initiation which Pilot Babaji gives to the people is Samadhi Diksha. So the blessings for the Samadhi. But normally he easily may give first three levels, but the last level he just normally first he's not so, okay, it's not so easy to get from him, because normally people just sitting next to him and not practice well, so, and he is giving only for some people this Samadhi Diksha. That's how he's like teaching people, and all that four levels, it's a kind of Shaktipat. So it's like, anyway, it's a huge blessings, and it's not like intellectual instruction, it's not like technique, it's not like seminar, let us say, a workshop. I mean, after that, dikshas, people, not they, they're just receiving some blessings, but no any like instructions or techniques. It's like just a powerful, huge blessings.